at this time, the family is really, you all really need help. Talk about, you know, the plea for help for your brother.
Right now, we're pleading for help from Governor Kay Ivey to give us time to take a look into this case. There are so many inconsistencies with the case. There's just so many different things that need to be looked at. An innocent man is scheduled to die, which is my brother. And the actual shooter has stated this multiple times in different ways. He's written letters. He's testified in the very beginning. He's called into CNN and also stated that Nathaniel Woods is innocent. He did not plan anything. He has not killed anyone. And still to this day, we have him in this prison that he's been in for 16 years for a crime he did not commit. In the transcripts, and this is why I urged everyone to go to savenate.com, because the full report is there so everyone can read it. The world has been reading these documents and they have agreed that Nathaniel Woods is innocent. All we need is that we need Governor Kay Ivey and her legal team to look through these documents or grant clemency, a stay, reprieve, something, so that this information could be put in a courtroom so that a judge can review this information and decide whether a new a retrial is needed. We can't just go by false information that was provided in the very beginning, counsel that was not, you know, up to the task of taking on this case. Even the prosecutor at the time questioned the attorneys, whether they were qualified enough to take on this case. So that in itself says a lot. There are many things that are being said about, you know, Nathaniel not giving up, but clearly the officer, Officer Collins, the surviving officer, has stated that he surrendered prior to the gunshots being fired. All of this information is in the transcripts. All that we're asking is that we have time to have this information in a courtroom so that it can be reviewed and then he can have a fair trial. We're asking Governor Ivey to please just give him a chance to have a fair trial. He's had it hard enough for something he hasn't done. Please have a heart, put the politics aside. Look at this case as if it was a family member of yours, a son, a brother, a father, and just, you know, I don't see what the rush is. So why not, you know, give some time to look through this information before making the mistake of killing an innocent man? That's something you can never take back. You can never take that back. And if you kill him today and then find out tomorrow after looking through the documents that he's innocent, what does that mean? Does that make, you know, the state of Alabama a murderer? Should, you know, the officials that, you know, called on this execution be also executed because you've executed an innocent man? How does this system work? We need time to prove his innocence. He's done nothing wrong. If there was going to be a setup, I'm sure that anyone that's going to set someone up that's coming to kill them would also have some type of way to defend themselves. Nathaniel did not have a gun. Nathaniel did not set anything up. The actual shooter was asleep at the time that Nathaniel Woods was being detained. How do you plan that? You cannot plan being detained and someone else being asleep and waking up and start just shooting a gun. He ran for his life just like anybody else in that apartment did that day. I would run for my life if somebody just broke out in gunfire. And I think anybody else watching this right now, if you're in somewhere, apartment, house, a building, a party, whatever, if you hear gunshots, what do people do? They run. And that's exactly what my brother did. He was sprayed with mace. He ran into walls. He had a big knot on his head. He made his way out the bathroom window. Kerry Spencer was still left behind, still shooting the officers. You cannot say that is a setup. That is not a setup. He was not complicit in any of this.
And before we go forward, just let us know who you are again for those that are just joining in. What's your name?
Pamela Woods. I'm Nathaniel Woods' sister.
Okay. And today, have you had any words? Were you allowed to visit him? Any discussions with him?
Yes, we were able to visit him. We just left him.
Can you talk about how he's feeling and, you know, his thoughts on this?
He's in his good graces. You know, he's positive and he's staying up. he's come to terms with everything. Even if it goes south, you know, he's glad he's going to go the way he's going to go. I don't mean it like that, but I mean of the people he's going with and the people who are going to take care of him, he's okay with that, and we've all come to terms with it as well if it doesn't go as planned. But we all know for a fact that my uncle is innocent, and people like Attorney General Steve Marshall, he's out there to kill my uncle, and he lied on my uncle, and he said that my uncle is a cop killer. A cop killer? Is that really what you're going to label someone who didn't even hurt anyone, who wouldn't even hurt a fly? And we all know he didn't have a gun, he didn't shoot anyone, and he didn't kill anyone. So there is no reason for you to call him a cop killer. And not only that, he also said that my uncle tried to lure those cops into the house. But we have it in his court document right here saying that he did not do that.
Transcripts.
And not only that, he also said that my uncle didn't surrender. But right here in the transcripts again, it says it. His word does not go against the transcripts. It does not.
And these are words of the surviving officer, Collins. He stated that my brother surrendered. He stated that my brother did not have a gun. He stated that my brother did not shoot anyone. These are Officer Collins' words. So why is Steve Marshall contradicting what Officer Collins is saying? Is he saying that Officer Collins was lying when he was on the stand? Or is Steve Marshall lying? I don't know. I don't get it, and I don't understand why they're trying to rush to this decision to execute my brother. And I know that there's a lot more behind this story that we're not trying to really talk about. But when you really think about it, what's the rush? What's the rush when you're saying that you want justice? Just like we want justice for those officers also, what you're gonna get. I mean, you have the actual shooter. He said what he did, why he did it. So what's the rush when you have someone who's innocent that's telling you, hey, I need you to look at the dash cam footage, which was never recovered. Hey, I need you to look at this. I need you to check this. I need you to test my shirt for the mace. Check my footprint in the tub. He's telling you the things to look for that proves his innocence. But yet and still, you ignore this information. So all we're asking is, we need time to have the courts to look through this information and grant a reprieve, grant clemency, anything to look through this information, because you cannot bring him back. You can't bring him back once you find out the truth. So it's best to find out the truth first and then make decisions later. Just like we want justice for those officers, we also want justice for Nathaniel too. Justice doesn't go one way. It should be for everyone. So justice for Nathaniel in finding out that he's innocent. Everyone has been looking at these documents, and they can clearly see that he's innocent and that he didn't do anything wrong. But how do we get Governor Kay Ivey to see this? How do we keep her from executing an innocent man and then later finding out that you just killed an innocent man? You just took a man from his children, from his grandchildren, from his family, a man that hasn't done anything but helped people. My brother had a heart of gold. When he was out, all he did was take care of people, help people. That's how he ended up in a situation, helping someone, trying to get somebody a place to stay.
So do you all feel like that you all are being ignored because the victims, the three deceased, are police officers?
Oh, definitely. Oh, yeah. Yes. Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
There's a whole lot of things that they don't want to talk about and that they don't want to cover only because those were police officers. And if you ask people of that neighborhood, they'll tell you some things about those police officers that those people, that the media and everyone else don't want to disclose. You get what I mean? So that's the only thing that we're really worried about, is getting that information about those officers out there so they can really see what was really going on.
Okay. Any other comments about, you know, related to him, since you all had, you know, you all were able to visit him? Are there any other comments?
I just really wish Governor Kay Ivey would really look deep into her heart and her soul and make the right decision, because this is an innocent man. And all this information that everyone in the world is reading, they can read it and clearly see that he's innocent. All we need is for you to give him some time. for the courts to go over this information and just have the truth come out.
Have you all, you, so you all, to be clear, you all haven't heard anything from the governor's office? I know yesterday you were you down in Montgomery?
Yes, yes, we were in Montgomery.
Did she make time to meet with you all?
No, we did not meet with her. But we haven't heard anything from the governor yet. We're still waiting to hear back from her, and I'm just hoping that she will make the right decision. And I promise you, Governor Ivey, if you give him the time and your team looks through the documents and the courts look through the documents, you will see that you actually saved the life of an innocent man. You saved the life of an innocent man. Save his life. We are pleading with you to save his life. He has done nothing wrong. There are a lot of discrepancies in this case. And if you look through it yourself, you will clearly see that there are so many things that went wrong. So many things. And we really need your help, Governor Ivey. We need your help to save an innocent man's life. That's what we need.
Any comments about the celebrities, people that are considered dignitaries that have spoken out?
Oh, wow. Yes, we are so grateful for everyone who's reached out, everyone who's read it, because a lot of people don't read nowadays. No one reads. If it's longer than a paragraph, they're done with it. But people have actually been reading through the summary that's on SaveNate.com, and they've actually been seeing all the different things that's in there that went wrong, and they're agreeing with this case. It's just really messed up. And they also agree with us that Kay Ivey needs to look at this case and grant clemency so that he can actually, you know, it's hard for his kids to see this happening. It's been 16 years that he's lost of his life for something he did not do. 16 years now in execution before the actual shooter?
Yeah.
That's insane. And everyone is seeing this. You can see just how insane this craziness. The craziness just goes on from the very beginning of this case up until now. It's just insane, and it's uncalled for. It's not necessary. This is a life we're talking about. A life.
Okay.
And it doesn't hurt anyone to take time, a few months or however long, to look over this case to make sure that this man is innocent before you call for an execution. So we're asking for time. We're not asking for him to be released today. We're asking for time to have this case reviewed so that an innocent man is not killed today.